Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the chapter 2, the next topic, that is megascopic identification of primary and secondary minerals. Let us see how we identify the primary minerals and secondary minerals. Before going into the topic, we should know what do you mean by primary minerals, what minerals comes under primary category and what minerals comes under secondary category. So before going into it, first we have to know how the soil and solid fraction is calculated. Here, the blue portion, the dark blue portion is taken as air. The dark violet is water. And this is a mineral portion. And this is the organic portion. So exactly the 50% is solids and the 50% is pores. Under pores we have air and water. Air and water, where air contributes to 25% and water contributes to other 25%. Coming to solids, we have minerals and organics, where minerals are only 45% and organics are just 5%. The total contribution is 100%. This is the soil solid fraction you have to know. Coming to the next, rocks break down. How they break down? With the help of weathering by the physical means. Let us see how does this happen and what is the criteria behind it. Generally, rocks will get breakdown. We have already seen in the earlier slides that they break down due to the natural phenomenon of the weathering. So, after rocks break down with the help of the weathering or by the physical means, there may be some other minerals which are formed. Those minerals are known as primary minerals. The rocks which break down further with the help of weathering with the source of physical means. Hence, those minerals are known as primary minerals. Here, what are primary minerals? There are some examples like quartz, feldspar are denoted by silica, aluminium and oxygen. Let me write. Primary minerals. Example, quartz, feldspar. I already told you the maximum of the part is generally covers the silica. These are denoted by Si, that is silica, aluminium and some parts of oxygen. Okay, here what happens is primary minerals are generally formed with the help of the breakage of rocks. That is, that process is known as weathering by the means of physical means, and they are denoted by Si, Al and O. So generally these primary minerals again break down principally by the chemical means. If they are break down by physical means, primary minerals are formed, and quartz, feldspar are the example. Again further, primary minerals are break down by the weathering with the help of chemical means, they are known as secondary minerals. Generally, silicate clays, iron oxides, aluminium oxides are the examples. So, here silicate clays, clay minerals are denoted by Si, Al and O. This is the point you have to remember. Silicate clay minerals are denoted by Si, Al and O. What is Si? Silica, aluminium and oxygen. So these are the, here we are finding in primary minerals also and secondary minerals also. So the rocks which break down with the help of physical means, primary minerals are formed. Again, these primary minerals are break down with the help of chemical means, then secondary minerals are formed. What are the examples of primary minerals? Quartz, feldspar, biotite, albite, muscovite are the examples of primary minerals. So what is the formula of quartz? SiO2, again silica and oxygen. Feldspar, silica, aluminium and oxygen, major content. Biotite, potassium, magnesium, aluminium, silica, oxygen and O2, OH, hydroxide. Albite, sodium, aluminium, silicon and oxygen. And a muscovite, potassium, aluminium, silicon, oxygen and hydroxide. Here, if you observe, every mineral is having some amount of Si, Al and oxygen. Okay. Since we have already learned in the previous slide, these are the major minerals which are occupied in primary minerals and also secondary minerals. Coming into the chemical alteration and the reorganization process, how does it take? First, we know that by the weathering of the physical agents, primary minerals are formed like quartz, feldspar, biotite, albite and muscovite. Again, here, these primary minerals undergo physical weathering and secondary minerals are formed, which are crystalline, aluminosilicate and clays. Again, these are dominated by main things, aluminium, silicon and oxygen. This is a brief slide which we have studied further. Okay, this is very important. Primary minerals by physical weathering. After primary minerals undergoing chemical weathering, these secondary minerals are formed. Here, which are very much dominated by aluminium, silicon and oxygen. Okay, this is an important slide. Please note down. Coming to the silicate clays. What are silicate clays? They are colloidal in nature. They are colloidal in nature. And what happens is, the three points you have to remember are, they are very small, nothing but less than 1 micron. That's why they are told to be colloidal in nature. They have a very large surface area. Coming to the surface area, they have large surface area. And they are highly very reactive. They are highly reactive in nature. So silicate clays are colloidal in nature. The size is about less than 1 micron. They have large surface area and they are highly reactive. These are the points you have to remember. Coming to the silicate clays. Coming to constituents of silicate clays, they have aluminosilicates. So, nothing but Si4H, silicon, aluminium, 3H, these are the electrons, these are the protons which are present in the valence shell. And oxygen, 2 electrons, OH, hydroxide, 1 OH. So, nothing but these 4 ions are arranged together to form the crystals. So, these are the 4 ions which are rearranged to form the crystals with a number of important properties which are reacted or related to the soil reactivity. Let me repeat. These 4 ions are arranged together to form crystals with a number of important properties which are related to the soil reactivity. So here what happens is, to form aluminosilicates, Si, silicon, aluminium, oxygen, hydroxide, these 4 ions, they have to arrange together in such a way that they are forming a crystal. And they are related to the soil activity. Here 4 plus, 3 plus and 2 minus and O are the ions which are present in the valency electron shell. We have the electrons which are present in the outermost shell are known as valency electrons. Okay, good. Coming to the ions, what are ions actually? Let us discuss what ions mean. So, Silicate clay minerals are crystalline and formed by specific arrangement of ionic forms of silicon, aluminium, and oxygen, which we have seen in the earlier slide. These ions are stable forms of elements that possesses an electrical charge. We have already seen these are the electrical charge 4 plus, 3 plus, 2 minus, and minus. Cations are elements that have lost electrons to become positively charged. These are cations. And anions are elements that have gained electrons to become negatively charged. So let me repeat. First point, what are ions? Silicate clay minerals, which are crystalline, and formed by, please note down, and formed by specific arrangement, of ionic forms. What are the ionic forms? What we have seen? Nothing but silica, aluminium, and oxygen. Okay. Here, the ions are stable forms. Stable forms of elements. What are ions? Ions are the stable forms of elements that possess an electrical charge. This electrical charge may be positive or negative. Elements that possesses an electric charge. Coming to the electric charge, here you can see these are all the electric charges. It may be positive and negative, anion and cation. Let us see. Cations are elements. So let us see what are anions and what are cations. Cations are elements that have lost electrons. When they will lose some electrons, they will be positively charged. When they gain electrons, they will be negatively charged. So the cations are elements that have lost electrons to become positively charged or less charged. And what are anions? Anions are electrons that have gained the electrons to become negatively charged. Anions are elements that have gained the electrons to become negatively charged. These are the important points you have to remember. These silicate clay are the minerals which are generally crystalline in nature, and they are formed with the specific arrangement of the ions of Si, aluminium, and oxygen. Again, coming to ions, they are very much stable forms which possess a specific electrical charge. This electrical charge may be positive, may be negative. What are positive? Positive are known as cations. How positive is formed? By losing. By losing. How negative are formed? By gaining. These positively charged ions are called cations and negatively charged ions are called anions. Please don't get confused. This is an important slide you have to remember. Okay. So these are the elements. We know this is a periodic table of elements we have seen in chemistry. These are the electrons which will revolve in a specific shells. The protons or the positively charged particles are present at the center with the nucleus. So these elements in the periodic table have equal number of protons and elements, electrons. Here, whatever, if you pick any element like helium, the atomic number is 2. Means it has 2 protons and 2 electrons. They are not ions. They are elements. For example, if you take calcium, it will have 20 protons and 20 electrons. So, this is an important point. They are electrically neutral. That's why they have equal number of protons and electrons. Once look at this periodic table. I think you already aware of this periodic table in intermediate. Okay. Yes. Coming to ions. What are ions? Ions are nothing but Ions are stable forms of elements that acquire an electrical charge by gaining or losing electrons. So, coming to the definition, I repeat, ions are stable forms of elements that acquire an electric charge. How they will acquire electric charge? Either by gaining or losing an electron. Electric charge either by gaining or losing electrons. So if you take an example, elemental sodium is Na. How much is have? I told you, elemental means it have equal number of electrons and equal number of protons. We have seen this here, 11. This is a elemental form. It is an elemental form. It has equal number of protons and electrons. So, what is the number of sodium? That is 11. So, it has 11 protons. Protons are denoted by positive sign. And electrons, 11 electrons, it denoted by negative sign. But sodium ion, why ion? So in order it has to be stable, it has to lose one electron, that is neon. This is a stable electron which is present near to it. So it, the number is 10. So the sodium number is 11. So it has to lose one electron. If it is losing one electron, it means it is losing one proton also, and it will become stable in nature. Hence, the elemental form will change to ionic form. So, it is losing and it is positively getting charged. Hence, it has what happens is, when it is losing, it has 11 protons and it is only losing the electron, not the proton. This point you have to remember. When it is losing, it is having 11 protons positive, but it is losing only electron. The protons at the nucleus are not losing because they are inside. They are not that easy to lose. Okay. So, by losing an electron, sodium has more protons than electrons and it will become positively charged. By losing, it will become positively charged. By gaining, it will become negatively charged. So, nothing but Na minus 1 electron will become Na plus. This is an important point you have to remember. Don't get confused. If it is losing one proton, it does not mean it will also lose one electron. Okay. I'm sorry if you get confused in the earlier discussion. It will only lose one proton, but not, it will only lose one electron, but not one proton. See, this is what will happen. SP DF, you know this. So in this shell, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, here what happens is we have SP SP DF. These are all the things how electrons will revolve around the nucleus. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 and 11, this is an extra electron which has to get loose. See. And it will become positively charged. When it is reacted with water, then 2NaH plus 2OH minus plus H2R form. Okay. See, this is what happens. The reaction will take place in this format. Again, coming to ions, we already know ions are nothing but stable forms of elements which acquire an electrical charge by gaining or losing an electron. Now, let us see chlorine example. Elemental chlorine will have 70 number of protons and 70 number of electrons. Chlorine is also near to argon, so it has to gain one electron. So, let us see what happens. For gaining, it has to take one electron. So, there will be 18 electrons and only 17 protons. By this way, by gaining an electron, chlorine has more electrons. Hence, it is negatively charged. That is Cl plus 1e minus is equal to Cl minus. This is a point you have to remember. See, this is the picture of chlorine. It has 17 protons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 17. One electron is joining to become stable. So, it is negatively charged and Cl minus ion is formed. So, elements that lose electrons and become positively charged are called cations. But the elements which gain electrons and become negatively charged are anions. Examples are Na plus, K plus, Ca 2 plus, magnesium 2 plus, copper 2 plus and ferrous 3 plus. Similarly, elements that gain electrons and they will become anions. Example, chlorine, bromine, fluorine, iodine are the examples. Okay, these are the points you have to remember. They are losing and becoming cations. They are gaining and becoming anions. Cations are positively charged. Anions are negatively charged. These are all also example. These are known as oxoanions with respect to oxygen. So, this is electrostatic attraction between Na plus and Cl minus. Negative attracted to positive and negative it is attracted to positive in this format. Coming to salts, what do you mean by salts? Salts are nothing but they are formed by combining cations and also anions to form solids. They don't have any charge. Let me repeat. Salts are formed by combining cations and anions to form solids that have no charge. Okay, when positive and negative will combine, there will be no charge. It is neutral in nature. So, cations, example, potassium, sodium, magnesium and calcium, chlorine, CO3 and SO4 are the anions. You have to see the power, positive and becoming anion, negative and becoming cation, plus, 2 plus, 2 plus, minus, minus 2, minus 2. Okay. Let us take one example. K plus and Cl minus is nothing but potassium chloride. So, this is a chemical reaction which is taking place between potassium and chlorine. Example, Na plus Cl gives rise to NaCl. We all know sodium chloride is a common table salt which we are using in our day-to-day life. These are some of the examples. KCl, NaCl, MgCl2, CaCO3, calcium carbonate, calcium sulfate, magnesium chloride. These are all crystals which are formed. Or solids which are formed by reacting the cations with the anions, and these are known as salts. I repeat, how salts are formed? They are formed by combining the cations and anions to form the solids that have no charge. Here they have neutral charge and they are electrically charged, that is neutral charge. No positive or no negative at the head, that is they are not ions, they are only solids which are formed by combining with the anions and cations. Let us see what are building blocks for silicate clays. Okay. What are building blocks for silicate case? Silicon tetrahedral and aluminium octahedral are the main building blocks for silicate clays. What is tetrahedron? Nothing but the four. Tetra means four. What is octa? It's eight. So here, this will form the tetrahedron shape. And what is this? The bigger zero is nothing but the oxygen. And this is silicon. Silicon will need four plus charges. So it will get and combine with the four oxygen. Oxygen is ready to combine with the four silicons. Hence, this is a silicon tetrahedron for example. And here let us see, what is this yellow color circle? It is hydroxide, that is OH minus. And what is this aluminium? This is one of the building block where it is ready to combine with the OH minus, that is hydroxide ion. And here it will become one of the building blocks for the silicate clays. So the main building blocks for the silicate clays are silicon tetrahedron and aluminium octahedron. So silicate clays are very important. Whatever minerals you take, they have maximum presence of silicate into it. What are the other minerals which are present? Silicate is a major part, aluminium and oxygen. If you see, these are all the minerals which are generally present in all the outcomes which are happen in the reaction. Okay. So this is a brief study of the things, how ions are formed, how cations are formed, how are anions. We have also discussed a few things from the basics also. I hope you understood the concept clearly. Thank you.